Hello, and welcome to this ArcherPoint presentation on recurring journals in Business Central. My name is Alex Wiley. I'm a senior pre-sales consultant here at ArcherPoint. I'll be leading you through this demonstration today. Let's go ahead and hop into our recurring general journals. I've set up two lines as an example. The first one is a recurring method of fixed. This means that every time we post our journal, our amount that we set will remain the same. We can also set a recurring method of variable. And this means that when we post our journal, the amount will go back to zero because we expect the value to change every month. I also have a second line here for reversing. The reversing entry will put this amount into the accounts we've selected on this posting date. And then on the next posting date, it will reverse them automatically so that we don't have to have multiple lines that we've entered for things like doing accruals. My recurring frequency shows how often I would like the posting date to advance when I post the recurring general journal. So in this example, I would post and it would advance the posting date by 1 month to October 30th. If we always want the value to be the end of the month, for example, for our reversing entries, we always want to make sure that's the last month. And as we're moving from month to month, that last day can change. We have a special value here. We set the recurring frequency to 1 day plus 1 month minus 1 day. This calculation ensures that every time you post, it keeps the posting date on the last day of the month. Let's go ahead and look at our allocated amounts. On our first line, we have rent expense, and I've assigned a department code to the line because I want the entire rent expense to go to my administrative department. If we look inside our allocated amount, we can do a single allocation for 100% of the value. This will put $7,000 all to the administrative department. However, if we would like to allocate based on different percentages across different departments, let's go ahead and look at our accrued salaries and wages. Here we can see that we have three different department codes. I can set up my allocation percentage so that this ends up totaling 100%. And regardless of whether or not this is a fixed amount or a variable amount, it can keep my allocation percentages in. Even though I have a variable amount every month, it's going to continue to assign that amount by percentage to each of these departments. It's a very helpful way of automating how you're breaking out what your costs are when you're posting these month to month, even when it changes. That's the general overview of the recurring general journals. If you have any questions about how to use various recurring methods or have questions about the recurring frequencies or anything else that we've covered today, feel free to leave a comment below or reach out to us at ArcherPoint and we'll help you.
Thank you for watching this ArcherPoint video. Stay in the know with the latest on Microsoft Dynamics by subscribing to our channel. You can also learn more from our blog at archerpoint.com or email info@archerpoint.com to contact us. See you in the next video.